everybody, welcome to a new weekly reading vlog, and this is going to be a very exciting one because it's also the first week of Believeton. So if you don't know, I've talked about it before, but if you don't know, Believeton is a middle grade and children's books readathon organized by Gavin from How to Train Your Gavin. It is amazing. There's so much work and effort put into this readathon, and I am participating again. I also did so in the last round, which was in May. Now it's November and it's time for another round. It's now Believeton round 3. If you want to know what I'm planning to read, I would highly suggest watching my November TBR video, because I talk about all the books that I want to read for this readathon in that one. So I will leave a link to that down below in the description box. So yeah, if you want to know more about that, I don't know if you're interested in that, but if you are, you can watch that one. But now it is Monday, the 2nd of November, and actually Believeton started yesterday because it did start on the 1st of November. But I personally haven't really started yet because I still had to finish another book that I was reading, and I did so yesterday. So now I'm finally all ready to be reading the first middle grade book of this readathon. And that book is going to be Nevermore by Jessica Townsend. So I think actually you're supposed to read the reading challenge for the key first, which is to read a mystery. But I'm sort of bending the rules a little bit because I really, really do want to read Nevermore. Like, I'm the most excited about this one on my TBR. So I'm just going to read this one first. And yeah, I know it's probably not exactly how you're supposed to do it, but I'm still doing it anyway because I really want to read Nevermore and I just cannot wait. I literally have no patience left. Somehow I just have to read it right now. It's been on my shelves for ages, but somehow I cannot wait another couple of days anymore because, yeah, I'm such in the mood, like so in the mood for this one. Nevermore is about a girl named Morgan Crow, and she's cursed, and everything that happens that is bad is blamed on her. And then on her 11th birthday, she's supposed to die, but somehow she's being whisked away to the mysterious town or land of Nevermore. As you can probably tell, I'm not that well prepared, but I do know that it's apparently very, very good, and so many people really love it. I know that Gavin talks about it a lot and that he really, really loves it, so I'm trusting his opinion when it comes to middle grade because he basically is like the king of middle grade on BookTube. But there are lots of more positive reviews about this one, so I cannot wait to delve into this beautiful, magical story, especially because this week is going to be a busy one. I have lots and lots to do for my master's degree. I have like three deadlines, lots of other things that I need to do. Yeah, it's a busy week, so I think it's just perfect to have this book, to have this magical, beautiful adventure for me to sort of escape to when I need a break. Because I do feel it is important to make breaks every once in a while, especially like I've talked about it many times before, but I do read before I go to sleep. So after a busy day this week, I cannot wait to delve like into this beautiful fantasy story. And like, oh, I'm so excited for it. My expectations are very high. And you can find out with me throughout this reading vlog if I'm actually going to love it. I think I will. I'm pretty sure I will. But yeah, that is what I'm going to read. I'm going to start with it tonight. Like, I cannot do it this afternoon yet because, as I mentioned before, I have lots of deadlines. But I'm very much looking forward to it, to be starting it tonight. So that's going to be a lot of fun. Oh, I'm so excited about Believeton, in case you can't tell. Then I'm also listening to an audiobook, but that one isn't really one for Believeton. It's just one that I'm supposed to finish because I have been listening to it for a while and I put it on hold, but now I do sort of want to finish it. Also, if the lighting keeps changing, that's because the weather today is basically completely dark or bright sunshine, and there's no in between, and it's going on and off the entire time, so apologies for that. But anyway, the audiobook that I'm listening to is the one of The Last Book of the White by Cassandra Clare and Wesley Chu, which is sort of a side series to the Mortal Instruments / all the other Shadowhunter books. It's the second book in the series, and it follows Magnus and Alec, and it's basically just, you know, a couple of their adventures and a bit of a story going throughout. Not sure if I'm explaining it well, but also, yeah, I'm now about halfway through, and I'm sad to say that I really don't like it all that much. And maybe that's because of the audiobook, because I don't know, the audiobook, just the normal narration doesn't really bother me that much, but when the narrator goes with certain voices, it does not sit well with me because it doesn't fit for me personally. It's not the kind of voice I would use for those characters, which is of course a personal preference, but somehow it just doesn't work for me. It annoys me a bit. Also, the story itself, the stakes just aren't that high because it is sort of a mythical. It takes place between, well, I'm not going to say, by the way, because maybe that is a bit of a spoiler, but it takes place somewhere along the main series. And the thing is with like mid calls, side calls, whatever you want to call it, the stakes just aren't that high because you know how certain things are going to end up. You know that certain things aren't going to happen, but somehow this book still tries to make it very exciting and tension build and everything. And there's no tension for me because I've read all the other Shadowhunter books. I know that it's just hard to explain, but somehow it's just not really doing it for me. I had the same with the first book. I was just not that invested, but somehow I'm liking this one even less. I don't know why, maybe because, I don't know. I honestly really don't know. I love all these Shadowhunter books very much, and I will definitely say that there's like a lot of fun time with your favorite characters. There's adventure, there's definitely a lot going on. If you're a fan of Magnus and Alec, then you will probably love it very much. And I do love Magnus and Alec, but just not that much that I like these books all that much. I just feel they're so not necessary. And not that stories within the Shadowhunter universe are always necessary, because there are so many. But to be honest, most of the stories usually pay off, and I'm guessing this one will also pay off a bit. I don't know what's going to come, but it's just, yeah, I don't know. I'm not really feeling it. That's also why I put it on hold for a little while, but now I do want to finish it, because having things left unfinished just really annoys me as well. And I have half an audiobook to go, and I'm sure I will manage to get through that somewhere during this week. So I'm just going to do it. It's not like I'm hating it, it's just a bit boring somehow. So that's it for the audiobook right now. It's not a Believe It On audiobook yet, because it's not middle grade, it's young adult. But you know, I'm just going to finish this one. It will be around like 3 stars or something. It's not going to be a new favorite, I can already tell. So don't expect many like exciting thoughts on this one, because I just don't have that many. It's not my favorite bit of the Shadowhunter universe. I love other books and other series better, which is just, you know, sometimes it happens, and that's fine. It's fine. It's just not the one for me. But yeah, that is pretty much it for the books that I'm currently reading, and I do really hope to finish both of them this week. Another fun random thing that might not really be of interest to anybody, but the day that I'm uploading this video, if I'm actually uploading it on the 9th of November, I am, I'm just going to make a promise with myself that I am, but it's the 9th of November, and today is my mother's birthday. I don't know if she watches my videos, like I don't think she watches all of them, but my mother is turning 50 on this day that this video is being uploaded. So I just wanted to say like a little happy birthday somehow in this video, because yeah, you know, 50, it's a nice age. It's an age that needs to be celebrated. And also, of course, my birthday is also coming up, because my birthday is on the 13th of November. So when you're watching this, it's at the end of the week. I'm going to do a special live show on the 12th of November for that, and also for my BookTube anniversary. I will leave links to the details to that down below in the description box, because I'm going to announce that somewhere this week. Lots and lots of fun things. So yeah, I just wanted to, I don't know, address that really quickly. And for now, I have talked enough, because I really need to get back to my assignment, because there's again a deadline. So yeah, I should probably do that, and then tonight I will have some reading time with Nevermore, and it's going to be amazing, I'm sure of it. Okay, my planning of this reading vlog did not entirely go as I had originally intended, because it is now Saturday night and I haven't filmed anything since last Monday. And in the end, it was because there was so much I had to do for school, like lots and lots of assignments and writing things, so I didn't have a lot of time to film. Also, I didn't really feel like filming because my mind just wasn't there. I have one thing that I've now handed in and another one that I have to hand in Monday, and then it's not going to be any like less busy because then it's the whole thing with like my birthday and moving and lots of things. So yeah, it's sort of like the situation as it is right now. I still need to film my October wrap up, my October reading wrap up. Don't know when that is going to happen, but you know, I'm just taking it as it comes, because yeah, there's just a lot that needs to be done. But I will give you another reading update, even though it's not that much, because I have started with Nevermore. By the way, you've probably seen it by now, like maybe in another video or something, but this cover, oh, it is so gorgeous. I'm so in love with it. I always take the dust jacket off because I find it very annoying with reading. But anyway, this cover, oh, I'm in love with it. But I've only read, 59 pages of this book so far. It's not much for a week of reading, but I will say though that the 59 pages that I've read, I really enjoyed. The start of the story so far is really, really promising, and yeah, it just sounds like it's going to be such a fun and magical adventure. I just have to find the time and sort of the like space in my head to actually read it, which is hopefully going to be better next week. I don't know. But you know, I am liking it so far. So it sounds good. It looks good so far. I'm sure I will finish it somewhere this month. Who knows? But I cannot tell you much about it apart from that because, yeah, as I said before, I haven't read much of it yet. Then for my audiobook, I have quit listening to The Red Scrolls of Magic. No, what was it called? Book of the Elder's Curses? No, the Last Book of the White. That's the one. I've quit listening to it for now because I just really found it too boring. I wasn't into it. And instead, I am now listening to an audiobook of a middle grade book that is on my TBR for Believeton. And that one is called Die Koning van Katoren by Jan Terlouw. This is a Dutch book by a Dutch author. It's kind of a middle grade classic, I feel, in the Netherlands. At least it was one of my favorites while growing up. I've always really loved this book and it has been ages since I've read it. I'm listening to the audiobook now and it's just, oh, I really enjoy it just as much as I did when I was younger. There are so many clever things in there. By the way, the Koning van Katoren means the King of Katoren. And it's about a 17-year-old boy named Stag who wants to become king because the land has been ruled by 6 ministers for the past 17 years. And they aren't very nice. So he's doing 7 tasks to become the next king. So yeah, it's sort of, you know, very much episodic because there are all these different tasks. And all of them have some double meaning. Like there's a town that he has to get rid of, like a dragon that causes a lot of, you know, air pollution. Like the air is horrible and everything. Which of course is also something that is an issue in real life. So things like that, they all have double meaning. And yeah, that is what I love about it. Also, some of the things are so funny, so cute. So I'm listening to this audiobook right now and it's not a very long one. So I'm pretty sure I will finish it soon, but I'm having the best time by rereading this one. It's one of my favorites when I was younger. And yeah, I don't know. I've tried to look it up if there are translations of this one. And the idea, I think, is that there used to be, but they're not in print anymore. At least it probably depends on the language. Which is sad because I feel like this is such a good book. Like, there's so much meaning in it and funny things. So I feel like lots of people will enjoy it. But yeah, I'm sorry. I'm not sure if there's a translation because I couldn't really find it. You can always try to Google the author and see if there is a translation in your country, but yeah, I cannot really help you with that, but I do really love this reread, so that is something that makes me happy. Now, as I mentioned before, it's Saturday night, and since we are living in 2020, there's not much I can do, so I'll probably just, you know, get into my pajamas, work on some school things, maybe read a little bit if I'm feeling really crazy. I think I will do that. I think I will read a little bit because now that I'm actually filming this reading vlog, I get more motivated to actually read. So maybe that's the key to solving, yeah, my wanting to read more. I don't know. That is what I'm doing right now, and I hope I can read more than what I've read so far, because it isn't much. Hey, it is now Wednesday, and I think it's safe to say that, like, all my predictions, all my hopes for this week and this reading vlog didn't exactly come true. Well, I did manage to finish all my assignments, so I guess that was a success somehow. Like, I don't know. I don't know if I've done well, but I'm just going to try to not to worry about that for the next couple of weeks. But we're now well into the second week of Believeton, and I sort of forgot to finish this reading vlog. It's really not my best reading vlog out of all of them, but I feel like I keep saying that with all the reading vlogs that I'm doing recently. It's just a very weird time. It's a fun time, there's lots of things happening, but also it's a very weird time. So what I said at the beginning, I think, is that I wanted to upload this vlog on my mother's birthday on the 9th of November. That did not happen because it's now the 11th. But anyway, you know, it is what it is. So yeah, also I think I talked about it before, but I am going to upload this one tonight because otherwise it won't make sense anymore. But I am going to do a live show for my birthday, my actual birthday and my BookTube birthday. Somehow birthday is a very hard word for me to pronounce. I can never do it correctly, but okay. So tomorrow on the 12th of November at 8 PM Amsterdam time, so like my time, I will start a live show for, you know, a celebration live show. It's going to be lots of fun. There are going to be special guests, some of my BookTube friends. So I hope you can be there. I will leave a link to the live stream down below in the description box. You can already like set a reminder if you want to. I really hope to see you there. It will be so much fun. I cannot wait. I'm so happy to sort of like celebrate my birthday, even though I cannot do it with like people in, you know, live in the flesh. Because of course that is not possible right now, but I can do it online. So that is what I'm going to do. And I feel like, you know, it is a good cause for a celebration. Also, yeah, my last birthday that I'm living in this home. My last week, basically, that I'm living in this home. Last 2 weeks or so. Yeah, so I will be doing moving vlogs because people ask. I will be doing moving vlogs. It's going to be starting now very soon. Yes, much excitement. I will give you a final reading update. It is not yet that mind-blowing. It hasn't been the best reading week. Although, by the way, no, I did finish a book. I did finish De Koning van Katoren. It is a very short book. Like, it's not a long one. It's like an audiobook of 2 hours or so, or like 3 hours. Not that much. But I did give it 5 stars because it's just one of my all-time favorites and I loved it so much. It's so funny. I love like the subtle jokes and the not so subtle jokes. It's just a cute, fun book and I love the sort of message of it and the magic and the sweetness and again the funniness. If you are Dutch, if you have read the book, then you probably know what I'm talking about, or not, maybe you didn't like it, I don't know. But I really love it and I really wish there was a translation for everybody because I feel it's such a universal middle grade book that is like so full of magic and yeah, I guess messages for everybody. So I finished that one. I actually also finished the audiobook of the Lost Book of the White. And this one I only gave 2 out of 5 stars because it was so boring. I'm so happy that I'm done with it now because I could not focus on it whatsoever. There are some cute moments, there are some fun moments, but overall I feel like this book is one big pile of unnecessary. And things that always have to be necessary, but if they're not necessary, then they should be really, really fun. And this wasn't really, really fun. It was sometimes a tiny bit fun. So really not doing it for me. I'm sorry. Like, I'm still a Shadowhunter fan, but not with this because it's just really not doing it for me. Yeah, I guess that's maybe also my reading mood. I don't know. Don't worry, I will still be reading Shadowhunter books. I will read like the next Chain of Iron, Chain of Gold. I don't know which one is the next. The Lost Hour series. I will be reading that at the beginning of the next year, but this one, this series, I guess, just not really for me. And then final reading update is very simple because I haven't read anything else of it, is Nevermore. And I was so enthusiastic at the beginning of this vlog and now I've barely read anything. Not because I don't want to, but because I feel like my mind is sort of like all over the place with so many different things. And yeah, then I somehow don't have mind space for it. I don't know. But yeah, I will be continuing with it this week. And hopefully I can get into a better reading mood. I'm going to try. But it's not because I'm not enjoying it. It's not because I don't want to read it. It's just life, I guess. So anyway, this is pretty much it for this reading vlog. I hope you still enjoyed it. It is a bit of a mess, but sometimes that's the case. And I guess that can still be fun. I don't know. But yeah, I'm going to end it here. And then again, I really hope I will see you at my celebration live stream. It's going to be so much fun. Please let me know if you're going to be there, like in the comments, and I will look forward to that. And yeah, of course, also very excited for this weekend, for my birthday and getting the keys to my own apartment. What? It's going to be very, very exciting. And yeah, this was it for this video. Again, I do hope you enjoyed it. And then hopefully I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye.